Hey there, my name is Samantha Holstine and I am a developer advocate at Camunda. And today I'm going to be talking about how Optimize can be super helpful to developers. While it's geared towards business logic, there are a lot of things that we can really dive in and use to get a lot of helpful reports, as well as pieces of information that might help us as we are developing our model. So to show how we can use and utilize Optimize, we're going to use a fairly simple trivia game here as an example. And just looking at this model, we're grabbing that trivia question, guessing that answer, going in, and depending on if we might need some help, we can go back here. If not, we're showing that answer. And if we won, then we're getting a celebration message. We win the game. Or if not, we lose a life or we lose the game. Fairly simple here. So let's dive into Optimize. When we dive into Optimize, the first thing I want to point out is that we can use it for error and incident handling. So when we create a new report here, we can grab a couple of really awesome templates. And the first one I want to show you is locating incident hotspots on a heat map. So when we create that report here, you're able to see a heat map of all of your incidents, both by resolution duration, which is how long did it take to resolve that issue, as well as by count and how many incidents actually happened. So when we change that here, you can really go and hover over all of these, showing the duration of where these incidents are happening, as well as going in and you can filter in by date, time, things like that. I'm going to press save. And I'm going to grab one other template here, going into that trivia game, and that is locating bottlenecks on a heat map. And this heat map will show how long each node spends on average on each part of your process. So as you can see here, it can really show if there are any issues. If you're highlighting over these, you can see the duration again on average where your process is spending time. Of course, for a trivia game, people are going to be spending time guessing that answer to the question, right? Maybe reading their congratulation or they're losing message. But you know, if we're plugging this into our own product, our own code or things like that, we can really show which tasks are maybe a candidate for automation, or maybe there is a little bit of a lag that we aren't expecting that we need to maybe dive into our code. Let's save that here. Go back to our collection. And lastly, we can also create our own reports here. So starting with a blank report, this really can be whatever you want. The world is your oyster, right? So when we create that report and create a blank report in here, we can really show almost any set of data that we have set up for our variables in our model. So for example, maybe let's show how many categories are played. So let's show the count. We're gonna group it by variable here, and the cool thing is when you're grouping by that variable, you're able to see everything in here. So showing that category. And we can also show this in a number of different ways, like a pie chart. That's definitely my favorite. You're able to see the categories of entertainment, science and nature, geography. And when we go in and we really dive into what we want to show, we can create a very robust dashboard here, which shows a whole bunch of different pieces of information for our trivia game. So for example, the different categories played, we're donating to charity, so which charity donations and how many, you know, how many losing donations, winning donations, as well as even a win-lose heat map down here where we can go in and see really where that happy path is for our trivia game and where people went to, which is really, really nice. On top of that, we can also dive into this analysis tab here at the top. We're able to see some more heat maps about either outliers. So going in, adding our trivia game, and really seeing where maybe some instances are taking longer than average or things like that, or maybe they're going down the wrong path, they're not going down the happy path, as well as this branch analysis, which gives you a little bit more of that probability again of how many instances are going down that happy path. So maybe with our trivia game, we want to see how many people who got a hint for their question made it to that happy path with winning, so we can see again that 49 0.5% of our process instances reach this rate for a trivia game, that's pretty good. Maybe for our actual code or things like that, we might want to dive into that a little bit more. And lastly, we also have a couple of other things that we can really dive into to optimize, especially our machine learning ready data set right here. And this is really nice because it can be a single data set for all of your exported data. You can really dive in, see everything and optimize and have it all there as well. So I hope that this was a quick and helpful tutorial to really make sure that we are utilizing Optimize to its full potential as developers on top of using that business logic as well.